Welcome. In this video I'm going to show you how you can determine the standard deviation using Python 3, and I'm using Jupyter Notebook. Sorry, Jupyter Lab actually. The standard deviation is a measure and perhaps the most popular one of them all. It's used usually as a measure of dispersion or variation and with a scale variable. It's the square root of the variance, and the variance is the average square deviation from the mean. So the standard deviation is roughly the average distance to the mean. Not exactly, that would be a mean absolute deviation, depending on how you define it. I'm not going to explain exactly what the standard deviation is, it's just about how to determine it using Python. I have seen a few different variations. There's the one where you divide by all data points, so that's usually for the so-called population standard deviation, which usually gets the symbol of sigma. We can divide by n minus 1, which is usually the one for the sample. That's actually then the corrected or the unbiased, as it's sometimes called. And on rare occasions, I even see a n minus 1.5, but you really have to dig deep to find those. For more information and a little bit more explanation of what it is, you can visit my website. This is the formula that it looks like, and let's dive in on how that works. To get an example, I'll need some sample data, and I'll be using a pandas. I'll import it as a pandas data frame, so I'll be needing pandas for that. If you've never used pandas before, you first have to install it and then you can import it. That goes for any of the packages that I might be using in this video. Then I can load it using the read CSV, using that pandas function. It gives me a small warning because the file is huge and I haven't cleaned up everything yet, but it's of no concern for us. We'll only be using the age category, and it's just as an example. I need a numeric field and age, although it looks like it, there are a few things with it. I'm first going to drop all the missing values in there. There is actually a category in there, 89 or older, so I'm going to just replace that with 89. That might not be the best thing to do, but it's just to get a numeric example and change all values to numeric, then with to numeric, because it might have some quotation single quote signs around each number, and I want to get rid of those so that they're reading numbers. So that's all being done in here, so I get my field 3, which should contain all the ages. Now if I want to avoid using any library, I need the length. So len is a built-in in Python, so I can use that, and I need the mean, which I can do by summing up all the fields or all the scores and then dividing it by the number of scores. I have a separate video on mean if you're interested in that. Then we can fill out that formula. As you can see, there's this first part underneath the square root sign. That's going to be the variance. There's this weird looking E, which is the sum sign. Then it's going to do all the scores. Those are the XEs. That's this one. Minus the sample mean. That's my mean in my case. It's going to be squared. So squared is going to be done with 2 times an asterisk. So that's the way in Python to get a raised to the power of. And then we divide all of that by n minus 1. So n minus 1, make sure you put that between parentheses. That gives me the variance. From the variance, we then need the square root. So square root is the same as raising something to the power of 1/2 or 0.5. So that should give me the sample standard deviation of 17.69 rounded. We can also use the standard deviation function simply from pandas. I already loaded pandas in, so this should simply work. And that's indeed the same result. Now, pandas also has actually a parameter ddOf, which is then used as n minus ddOf. So the default here is set to 1 because we got the exact same result as with our sample version, which was using n minus 1. So if I want to get, for example, the biased sample or the population standard deviation, I would set that to 0, and then it would simply divide by n minus 0, so dividing by n. And that gives me a slightly different number. Usually if you have enough data points, the difference is very small. So this is 17.68 rounded, this is 69 rounded. Python has its own library statistics, so you don't need to import or first install, install that package. It should come by default with Python. So from statistics, I can use then standard dev. I do need to import it, and then I can use it. And this gives me the, as you can see, the sample 169 rounded. The Python statistics library has a separate function for the population version where they simply put a P in front of it. So if we run that, we get that 17.68 rounded again. NumPy works almost exactly the same as Pandas, but it does it, the default is the exact opposite. So in Pandas, in NumPy, the standard one, if you don't put in any parameters, it will give you the population version. So I'll first need to load that in. Again, if you've never used NumPy before, you first will have to install it. And then, as you can see, this is the 68, so that's the population version. It does have the exact same ddauth as with Pandas. So if here I want to get the sample version, I set that to 1. So be careful if you're using Pandas or NumPy's version of the standard deviation, because their default is slightly different. If you want to be sure, just always specify the ddauth. All right, and that was it. I hope this video was helpful for you.